Now let us study the situation of projection of a charged particle at some angle to magnetic field. Say these are the magnetic line of forces of a uniform magnetic induction B. And in this region, say we are given with a charge plus Q, which is projected into the magnetic field with a velocity vector V at an angle theta to the direction of magnetic induction. In this situation, we can directly state a component of velocity which is V cos theta that will be parallel to the direction of magnetic induction, and another component V sin theta will be perpendicular to the direction of magnetic induction. Here we talk about the direction of motion of a charge parallel to magnetic field. It does not experience any magnetic force and it has a tendency to move straight. And the component of velocity with which the charge is moving perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field, it experiences a magnetic force, and here we can write magnetic force on the charged particle will be QVB sin theta, as theta is the angle between the two. So here we can write it is due to the component V sin theta, it is experiencing the magnetic force. If we just have a look on the direction of magnetic force, by right hand palm rule we can see magnetic induction is toward right. So if I point my fingers toward right and thumb along the direction of positive charge, so my palm is facing in inward direction. So it will experience the magnetic force in the direction into the plane of the surface. And due to this V sin theta, it will have a tendency to circulate the charge with its center lying in the direction of an axis passing through this point and perpendicular to the surface. And it will have a circulation tendency, and V cos theta will be having a tendency to pull it in forward direction. So resulting motion of this charged particle will be bounded in the cylindrical zone. And due to this component V sin theta, it will be circulating, and due to V cos theta, it will be continuously moving forward. So the resulting path of the particle will be a helical path. Here we can write this will be a helical path which the particle will follow. And the radius of this helical path RH will be due to the circulation of this particle by the speed V sin theta. So we can directly write here radius of this helical path, or radius of this helix which is traced by the particle, we can write as RH is equals to, the formula is MV by QB. So here we write MV sin theta by QB. That is the expression used for the radius of a helical path. Similarly, we can find out the pitch of this helix or the helical path, that is the distance covered by the particle during one complete revolution. So here it is following the path along the direction of magnetic field with the velocity V cos theta. So here we can write directly pitch of helix can be given as pH. This is V cos theta multiplied by time period of revolution. And the time period of revolution we can separately find out as 2 pi by omega. And we already studied that the value of angular speed is independent of the velocity of particle in a magnetic field, which is given as QB by M. So the time period of revolution here is 2 pi M over QB. If we substitute it here, pitch of helix we are getting is 2 pi mv cos theta by qb. This is the expression for calculation of pitch of the helical path, that is the distance covered by the particle along the direction of magnetic field during one revolution. And this actual situation of this helical path, we can also explain with a realistic situation. Let's continue on the next sheet to understand how this helical path is being traced by the particle once again. In continuation, let's discuss a realistic situation where we can practically understand how the helical path is being followed. Here you can see there's a uniform magnetic field in the region which exists from left to right. And from left side, a charge plus Q enters into it with a velocity V vector. For reference, we can consider the point where the charge is getting into the magnetic field as origin. Horizontal direction as X axis and vertical direction as Y axis, and in outward direction positive Z axis. Now here you can see the horizontal component of velocity V cos theta particle will not experience any force. So here we can say force acting on the particle due to V cos theta here is equals to 0. And force experienced due to the velocity V sin theta here will be QVB sin theta. And here you can see by right hand palm rule here, fingers are pointing in magnetic induction, thumb along the direction of V sin theta. So palm is pointing in the direction of minus Z axis. So we can put the unit vector minus K cap here. Now, if we just rotate the situation and have a look on the situation from the side of X axis, then we can see the magnetic force acting on the particle is due to V sin theta is toward left, and when the particle starts, it moving in a circular path due to V sin theta about the center C, which we can see here in the situation. So, the radius of this helical path RH, or you can simply say radius of this circle, is MV sin theta by QB. And if we just repeat the experiment and have a look on the situation once again, in three-dimensional situation here you can see when the particle is thrown, it follows the helical path in the direction of X axis, and if I look on it from the side of minus X axis, it looks like a circle, as the projection of a helical path on XY plane here is a circle. So with this realistic situation, you can understand how the helical path is being followed by the charged particle.